there is a power. When that power lands on you, it doesn't matter the environment, you shoot up.
There is power in the blood.
When that power landed on Isaac, in a season of famine, the man began to prosper and continued to prosper until he became very prosperous.
There is power in the blood to break the chains of bondage.
We destroy that bondage of fear in the name of Jesus.
The blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood. Power in the blood.
Lift your bones. We love you, Jesus. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you adoration. We celebrate you, mighty God. We celebrate you, Lord of glory. Shakatara kadala masete regene. Masatara kadala masitari kada. Reketele bobusa. Wherever you are, lift your voice. Worship the King of glory this morning. The Lord our healer, the Lord our savior, the Lord our deliverer, the Lord our restorer. He is our restorer. Lift your voice, everyone. Worship him. We bless you. Lord our healer, we honor you. Lord our healer, we celebrate you. Lord our healer, we magnify you. There is no God like 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 you. Lord, I give you praise. Lord, I give you glory. Thank you, mighty Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Somebody's life is taking a new turn in the name of Jesus. If I'm talking to you, shout your loud amen. And as I am preaching this morning, you shall see the manifestation of the healing power of God upon your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Whatever has been a limitation to your joy, your rising, your shining, your celebration, your progress in life will be broken this morning in the name of Jesus. I said it will be broken this morning in the name of Jesus. Whatever has been resisting your change of level is terminated today in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody is changing levels. In business, you are changing levels. In career, you are changing levels. Financially, you are changing levels. In all dimensions of life, you are changing levels. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, signs, wonders, and miracles are taking place in somebody's life here. I know you are one of them. Can I hear a loud shout of amen? In the mighty name of Jesus, I want to say to someone here that your life will be full of testimonies after now. I said after now, your life will be full of testimonies. Your life will be full of testimonies. I said your life will be full of testimonies. Somebody shout, my life will be full of testimonies. You see, when Jesus meets you, he does not leave you the same way he found you. Today, you are having an encounter with Jesus that will change your life forever. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You see, from now on, the power of God will be hitting you repeatedly for your continuous change of level. I said for your continuous change of level. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Somebody here is receiving a failure-proof anointing. Failure-proof grace. Failure-proof abilities. From now on, you shall never fail again. In business, you shall never fail again. In career, you shall never fail again. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Many of your contemporaries will be amazed with your level of success, your level of prosperity, your level of promotion, your level of advancement. Somebody shout, I am advancing. I am changing levels. I am moving up higher. I am moving up higher. I am moving up higher. Please, if that is you, can I hear your loud shout of amen? I decree this hour that anything called small shall never be part of your life. In the name of Jesus. Anything called small is wiped away from your life. It is wiped away from your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. You see, from now on, people shall look at you and they shall say, how come you are this successful? How come you are so great? How come you are so powerful? How come you are so powerful? And that shall be your testimony. I said, that shall be your testimony. You believe that? Clap your hands for the King of Kings. Come on, everyone, clap your hands more for Jesus, even this morning. You may be seated as we turn our Bibles, reading from the King James Version, Acts 28, verses 1 to 6. Now, this is a day of battle. A day of battle, if it is a day of battle, a day of victory for somebody here. Acts 28, verses 1 to 6. The Bible says, and when they were escaped, then they knew that the island was called Melita. And the barbarous people showed us no little kindness, for they kindled a fire and received us, everyone, because of the present rain and because of the cold. Wherever you go after now, you shall enjoy massive divine support in the name of Jesus Christ. No one here shall be stranded in life in the name of Jesus. And when Paul had gathered a bundle of sticks and laid them on the fire, there came a viper out of the heat and fastened on his hand. And when the barbarians saw the venomous beast, somebody shout, the venomous beast. When they saw the venomous beast hang on his hand, they said among themselves, no doubt this man is a murderer, whom though he hath escaped the sea, yet vengeance suffereth not to live. And he shook off the beast. Somebody shout, he shook off the beast. No. Lift your right hand and shout, he shook off the beast. And tell yourself, today I'm shaking off the beast. 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 Somebody here is shaking off the beast in the name of Jesus. Any beast that had attached itself to your life, to your business, to your career, to your health, to your family, to your children, will be shaken off your life today in the name of Jesus Christ. It will be shaken off your life this morning in the name of Jesus. And he shook off the beast into the fire and felt no harm. And felt no harm. Because that is what the master said. Behold, I give you the authority to trample over scorpions and serpents and over every power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means harm you. Nothing shall by any means hurt you. Glory be to God. Please, Acts 28, verse number 5. The Bible says, and he shook off the beast into the fire and felt no harm. Then verse number 6. Howbeit they looked when he should have fallen or fallen down dead suddenly. But after they had looked a great while, that is after they had waited for some time and saw no harm come to him, they changed their minds and they said that he was a god. The one they called a murderer, they said, now he must be a god. They must be a god. This man must be a god. He must be a god. He must be a god. Hallelujah. Now, listen to me. I'm speaking this morning on the subject, the beast must catch fire. The beast must catch fire. God is about to do something in your life that will make those around you to change their mind about you. They thought it would take you a long time to receive your miracle. But God is about to surprise those that were expecting such a thing, because anytime from now, that miracle is coming to you in the name of Jesus. Those who thought you would never get married, God is about to surprise them very soon. Those that thought you would never be promoted, your promotion will never come through, they will be shocked, because anytime from now, promotion is hitting you in the name of Jesus Christ. I said, in the name of Jesus Christ. I said, in the name of Jesus. God is about to give you a testimony that will change your reputation. I said, that will change your reputation. Some of you, they have never given you a chance for anything good to happen to you. But God is about to orchestrate a breakthrough that will turn your life forever in the name of Jesus Christ. I said that will turn your life around forever in the name of Jesus Christ. Because of limited time, let's begin to glean some lessons from the passage that we have read. Number one, we see that it is important for us to have a vision for life. It is important for us to have a vision for life. And I'm talking about that thing that should be the reason for your preservation, the reason for your existence, the reason for your preservation, the reason for your existence. Joseph was preserved because he had a leadership dream. Joseph was preserved because he had a leadership dream. The moment he got hold of the revelation of the dream, the leadership dream, it was impossible for any devil to kill him. His brothers could not kill him. Potiphar could not kill him. Anybody was not permitted to kill him. Moses was preserved because he had an assignment to deliver the children of Israel from the land of Egypt. Herod could not kill Jesus because he had a mission on earth. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 1 and verse number 21, you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. The question this morning is, what is your dream? What is your dream? You must have a dream that should be the reason for your preservation. If you are talking about living long, you must be wanting to live long because there is a dream that you want to achieve. That is an assignment that you want to accomplish. And I came to announce that whatever your dream may be, that dream shall come to pass. I said that dream shall come to pass. Paul had a dream. In this particular instance, Paul had wanted to reach Rome because he wanted justice to be done in his case, in his issue. But the beast in Acts chapter 28 wanted to stop him from reaching Rome. But you know that that beast was roasted by fire. Paul still reached Rome. I came to announce this morning that no matter what happens, you will reach your destination. You will achieve your dream. I said your dream shall come to pass. Nothing shall stop your breakthrough. Nothing shall stop your joy. Nothing shall stop your testimony. Nothing shall stop your favor. Nothing shall stop your success. In the mighty name of Jesus. And I came to announce that those that were angry with you shall be reduced to zero. I said they shall be reduced to zero. In the mighty name of Jesus, any beast, any power of darkness seeking to suffocate your destiny, to silence your dream, to scatter your plan, that power is destroyed in the name of Jesus. That beast is roasted in the name of Jesus Christ. Lesson number two we get from this passage is that every time you want to make a difference in life, that devil will try to rise against you. Every time you want to make a difference in life, that devil will try to rise against you. The devil will try to rise against you. Paul had a desire. Paul had a plan. Paul made efforts. The Bible says to add sticks to the fire. There was the fire, but he wanted more fire. He wanted to increase the fire. He wanted now. That should be the desire of every believer. Not to just be at the level where you have been. God wants you to change level. There was a fire, but Paul wanted the fire increased. There is money, but your money must increase. There is success, but your success must increase. The Bible says that when Isaac began to prosper, he continued prospering until he became very prosperous. Genesis 26 and verse number 13. In Proverbs chapter 4 and verse 18, the Bible says that the path of the just is a shining sun that shines ever brighter. Chance ever brighter. But when Paul made efforts to increase the fire level, there was an attack by this venomous beast. There was an attack. There are forces of setbacks that will try to rise against you in life. However, all such forces are catching fire right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, no matter what happens, everyone here shall reach where he or she is going in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, I'm going somewhere. Somebody shout, I'm going somewhere, and I shall reach there without fail, and shall arrive there without fail. Somebody shout, I will reach my destination. I decree this hour, poverty won't stop you in the name of Jesus. Sickness won't stop you in the name of Jesus. The economy won't stop you in the name of Jesus. Demonic forces won't stop you in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, I am unstoppable. Say it louder, I am unstoppable. Lift your right hand and shout, I'm too hot to be stopped. I am too hot to be stopped. I decree this hour. Now listen to me. It's amazing what is happening here, because Paul has gathered these bundle sticks. He wants to put them on the fire, and then the serpent bites him. The idea is, let him drop dead before he can make use of the sticks. Let him fall dead before he can put the firewood on the fire. So let him waste his energy. Let him waste his resources. Lift your right hand. I decree this hour, your resources shall not be wasted. You shall not waste your time. You shall not waste your energy. You shall not waste your resources. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lift your right hand and shout, my resources shall not be wasted. Some of you have wondered, what's the point of being in this career? What's the point of being in this marriage? What's the point of being in this business, when for all this time I still have nothing to show? I have made everything, I made every effort to achieve what I'm supposed to achieve, what I had wanted to achieve, what I had desired to achieve, but nothing but has been achieved. I have good news for you. This morning, the beast is catching fire. I said, the beast is catching fire. I said, the beast is catching fire. Any power that has been stopping your marital entrance is destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Any power that has been stopping your promotion is destroyed in the name of Jesus. Any power that has been stopping your rising is destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, I did not come to preach a conventional message. I came for a fight. I came for a fight. I am fighting against every enemy that has been standing in your pathway to stop your rising, to stop your shining, to stop your manifestation. The beast must catch fire. The beast must catch fire. I said, the beast must catch fire. In the mighty name of Jesus. Please, can I hear a loud shout of amen? You may be seated. What is this beast representative of? What is this beast symbolic of? We know from the pages of scripture that this beast is a picture of the devil and his works. The picture of the devil and his works. The Bible speaking in Revelation chapter 12. Please, can we have verse number 7 going down into 10. The Bible says, and war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought with the dragon, and the dragon and his angels fought, but they did not prevail, nor was there a place found for them in heaven any longer. So the great dragon, here this was cast out. Now listen to me. It says, that serpent of old, that serpent of old, that serpent of old, that venomous beast of Acts 28 is a picture of the devil himself and his work of stealing, killing, and destroying. John chapter 10 and verse number 10 says, a thief comes but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. To kill. Now that venomous beast wanted to kill Paul, wanted to destroy Paul, wanted to frustrate and scatter Paul, but it failed. The devil shall fail again in your life. He shall fail again in your marriages. He shall fail again in your careers. He shall fail again against your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. I said, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift your right hand. Any power of hell against your destiny is arrested in the name of Jesus Christ. Please, can I hear a louder shout of amen? And there is one characteristic of this beast that the Bible is highlighting in that Acts chapter 28. It says that this beast was venomous, to mean that it was poisonous. It was a poisonous snake, a poisonous beast. The enemy is poisonous. It transferred venom into the body of Paul, but the poison could not destroy Paul. It transferred its venom into, because the Bible says that it stuck itself, it struck Paul, it bit Paul, and it to mean that it transferred its poison into the body of Paul, but the poison was neutralized. No wonder the Bible says, no weapon fashioned against you shall prosper. And every tongue that rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. They shall surely assemble, but not by me. And whoever shall assemble against you shall fall for your sake. This shall be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. There are people today who cannot stay with one man or one woman in marriage. They are poisoned. There are people today who cannot stay in one church for 3 years. They are poisoned. There are people today who lose their mind every time they find money. They are poisoned. There are people today who cannot finish a month without getting sick. They are poisoned. There are people today who cannot stay for a week without picking a quarrel with their spouse or boss. They are poisoned. There are people today who can never get it right first time. They are poisoned. Any poison against your life that is somehow manipulating you and preventing you from being the best that you're supposed to be, that poison is cancelled. That poison is destroyed. That poison is destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I said in the mighty name of Jesus. What I've discovered in life is that this satanic poison can take many forms. It can take the form of evil covenants. It can take the form of curses. It can take the form of evil spirits. And these poisons can affect any aspect of human life. You can talk about your health, your finances, your career, your marital life, your progress. Whichever way that the devil has been trying to poison you, I scatter him in the name of Jesus. I scatter him in the name of Jesus. I scatter him in the name of Jesus. Lift your right hand and shout, all my enemies are scattered. This morning, that beast against your life must catch fire. As somebody shout, my every beast against me is catching fire. Say louder, every beast against my life is catching fire. Look at your Bible. God has always used fire to destroy his enemies. God has always used fire. Among other channels and strategies, he has always used fire to dismantle his enemies. For example, the Bible says in Psalm 97 and verse number 3. Psalm 97 and verse number 3, it says that a fire goes before him and burns up his enemies round about. I decree this hour that the fire of God is burning up all beasts that were against your life in the name of Jesus Christ. I said in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody shout a better amen. The Lord our God is a consuming fire. You know that? Deuteronomy chapter 4 and verse number 24, and I think Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 29 as well, that the Lord our God is a consuming fire. He is a consuming fire. That is why he can emit fire at any point to scatter all your enemies. Today, the beast is catching fire. Every beast that the enemy assigned to work against you, to fight against your health, to fight against your marital destiny, your financial destiny, to fight against your career destiny, that beast is catching fire right now. I said that beast is catching fire right now. I said that beast is catching fire right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Numbers 16 and verse number 35. Numbers chapter 16 and verse number 35. And the fire came out from the Lord and consumed the 250 men who were offering incense. I decree this morning, may the fire of God come down from heaven to consume all the enemies of your life, all the enemies of your destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus, lift the right hand and shout, the beast must catch fire. Say it like you mean it, people. The beast must catch fire. Say it better. The beast must catch fire. Now, take note of this from that Acts chapter 28 and verses 1 to 6, that the beast was inside the firewood. The beast was inside the firewood. The firewood. But it had to come out. so that the firewood could release its full potential. The beast was inside the firewood. Now, for the firewood to release its full potential, the beast had to come out. The beast had to come out. Beloved, where is this beast hiding in your life? For some of you, and for some people listening to me, the beast has been hiding in their personal life. That is why such people always get confused. They suffer rejection, dejection, restlessness, and they are always moody. Some people, this beast is hiding in their uterus. That is why they cannot conceive. They remain childless in their families, in their homes. For some other people, the beast is hiding in some other part of their body. That is why they are always living a sickly life. They are never getting right in their health. For some people, this beast is hiding in their workplaces and in their businesses. That is why they are being oppressed in business. Their business cannot rise because there is a beast hiding inside there. They can't rise in their workplaces. They can only receive oppression because the beast is hiding in their career. For some people, this beast is hiding in their homes. That is why, you know, there are some people, the only place they don't like to be is their home. The only place they don't want to be is their home. That is why the man will be arriving home 3 a.m. Where are you coming from? There's a beast in the house. There's a beast in the house. For some people, the beast is in their travels, in their trips. That is why every time they travel, they will be talking about tales of accidents. We almost had an accident. We were traveling to Mususu, a gender, something wanted to hit us. Because the beast is hiding in their travels. When the Bible says you are blessed in your going out, you are blessed in your coming in, the devil is a liar. I don't know where this beast is hiding in your life. Today, we smoke him out in the name of Jesus. Today, we smoke out the beast and we command it to catch fire. I said we command it to catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. The beast of cancer is roasted by fire. The beast of tuberculosis is roasted by fire. The beast of high blood pressure is roasted by fire. The beast of COVID-19 is roasted by fire. The beast of diabetes is roasted by fire. The beast of barrenness is roasted by fire. The beast of stagnation is roasted by fire. People, I said the beast is roasted by fire. The beast, now jump on your feet. Begin to prophesy. The beast is roasted by fire. The beast is roasted by fire. Come on, wherever you are, on ground, online, jump on your feet if you can. Lift your voice and begin to announce. The beast is roasted by fire. The beast is roasted by fire. The beast is roasted by fire. Wherever the beast has been hiding, I attack you. I attack you, beast. I smoke you out. I smoke you out. And I command you to catch fire. I command you to catch fire. Every beast that has taken our nation of Malawi ransom, we command you to catch fire. Every beast that has taken us hostage, that has taken our families hostage, that has taken our children hostage, you are roasted by fire. 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 In the name of Jesus, sickness and disease of any kind, financial stagnation, marital stagnation, ministry stagnation, business stagnation, you are roasted by fire. The beast must catch fire. The beast must catch fire. The beast is catching fire. The beast is catching fire. My God, the beast is catching fire. This morning, the beast is catching fire. The beast is catching fire. The beast is catching fire. The beast must catch fire. The beast must catch fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, every poisonous serpent, every venomous beast waging war against us for purposes of stealing, killing, and destroying, I scatter you by fire. I scatter you by fire. I scatter you by fire. The beast must catch fire. The beast must catch fire. The beast in my workplace. The beast in my health. The beast in my marriage. The beast in my career. The beast in this church. Catch fire. 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 The beast must 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 catch fire.
beast must catch fire. The 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 beast must catch fire. My God, my God, my God. Shakata ragada, mazuta rigadia, rakata rababusa, yakata rigada, shakata ragada, yakata rababusa, rakata rababusa, rakata rababusa, yakata rigadia, yakata rigadia, yakata rigadia, masata ragada, yakata ragada, financial beast, catch fire, in the name of Jesus, career beast, catch fire, in the name of Jesus, marital beast, catch fire, in the name of Jesus, ministerial beast, catch fire, in the name of Jesus, workplace beast, catch fire, in the name of Jesus, the beast is catching fire, 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 in the name of Jesus. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, we're not sitting down anymore because we are really set for prayer this morning. Now hear me. 2 Kings chapter 1 and verse number 10, 12 and 14. Oh my God. 2 Kings chapter 1 and verse number 10. And so Elijah answered and said to the captain of 50, if I am a man of God, then let fire come down from heaven and consume you and your 50 men. And fire came down from heaven. So as you command fire to come down to roast the beast, I want you to know that it is happening. I want you to know that it is what? Happening. Any demonic beast responsible for your pain in business, in life, in ministry is roasted by fire. I said it is roasted by fire. A fire came down. When the man of God pronounced it, the Bible says that immediately a fire came down from heaven and consumed him and his 50. Verse number 12. So Elijah answered and said to them, if I am a man of God, let fire come down from heaven and consume you and your 50 men. And the fire of God came down from heaven and consumed him and his 50. Verse number 14. My God, my God, look, fire has come down from heaven and burnt up the first two captains of 50s with their 50s. Oh, but let my life now be precious in your sight. They had to beg. They had to beg. They had to beg to say, please, this time, please. Now, lift your right hand. If I be a man of God, let that beast anywhere in your life fighting against you, trying to strangle you in life, put you under pressure, catch fire right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Let that beast catch fire right now in the mighty name of Jesus. We have no mercy on the devil and his cohort. We announce right now that every beast of hell against your life is roasted by fire. It 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 is roasted by fire. Father, in the name of Jesus, I command every beast working against my destiny to catch fire right now. Lift your voice and pray. 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 I command every beast operating against my life, operating against my destiny to catch fire, 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 to catch fire. My God, my God, my God, my God, my God, it is catching fire, it is catching fire, it is catching fire, it is catching fire. Every satanic beast operating against my house, operating against my children, operating against my wife, operating against my marriage, operating against my calling, operating against my ministry, operating against my destiny, be roasted by fire, 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 be roasted, 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 in the name of Jesus, the beast of sickness, the beast of fear, the beast of stagnation, the beast of financial struggle, the beast of delays, the beast of delays, I knock you down by fire. 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 Catch fire, 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 catch fire. Now, 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 now. In the name of Jesus. My God, my God. Look at this. Look at this. Something good is happening. Something good is happening to you. Something good is happening to your marriage. Something good is happening to your career. Something good is happening to your businesses. Something good is happening to your finances. Something good is happening to your health. Come on, somebody shout, something good is happening to me. 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 Mata! Shakata rigada. Listen to this. Psalm 140, verses 9 to 10. Psalm 140. Verses 9 to 10. My God. Now, this is awesome. This is awesome. As for the hate of those who surround me, let the evil of their lips cover them. He's the God of vengeance. Let burning coals fall upon them. Get back to verse number 9. He's talking about those who surround him. To attack him, to frustrate him, to confuse him, to drown him. He says, let the evil of their lips cover them, because they shall surely assemble, but whoever shall assemble together against you shall fall for your sake. So verse number 10 says, it says, let burning coals fall upon them. Let them be cast into the fire, into deep pits, hey, that they rise not up again. Somebody is going to pray. You are going to pray that burning coals should fall upon all the beasts behind the misery of your life and the misery of this nation of Malawi or any nation where you are watching us from. You are praying that the burning coals shall fall upon all the beasts behind the misery of your life, the misery of your career, the misery of your destiny, and the misery of your nation. And you're also praying, casting those beasts into the fire, into deep pits, never to rise up again. Lift your voice and engage the word of God in this matter. Come on, lift your voice, lift your voice. You are praying that burning coals shall fall upon all the beasts behind the misery of your life and nation. You are praying, casting those beasts into the fire, into deep pits, never to rise again. In the name of Jesus, every satanic beast, every satanic beast, all satanic beasts, all satanic beasts, all satanic beasts against our lives, against our families, against this church, against the nation of Malawi, be roasted by fire, 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 be roasted by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am praying right now that burning coals are falling upon all the beasts behind the misery of this nation, the misery of churches, the misery of the people, the misery of families, the misery of children, the misery of fathers and mothers. Yes, in the name of Jesus, I announce right now that burning coals are falling upon all the beasts against this commission, all the beasts against our families, all the beasts against the nation of Malawi. In the mighty name of Jesus, I announce this hour that burning coals are falling upon the beast of COVID-19. COVID-19. You are roasted by fire. 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 We scatter you by fire. We scatter you by fire. We demolish you by fire. We terminate you by fire. We terminate you by fire. in the name of Jesus. We cast all the beasts against our lives into the fire of the Holy Ghost, into deep peace, never to rise up again, 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 never to rise up again. We are casting all beasts, financial beasts, ministerial beasts, marital beasts, workplace beasts. We cast them into the fire of destruction, the fire of destruction, burnings of fire, burnings of fire, burnings of fire, all beasts of hell against us, all the beasts of hell and their cruelties against us, their hostilities against us, their wicked plans against us. We cast them into the fire, we cast them into the fire, into the deep pits, into the deep pits, into the deep pits, into the deep pits, never to rise up again, 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 never to rise. Ay 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 ay. Shakataragaga, basataragaga, yakatarakaka, yakatarakaka. The beast must catch fire. 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 The beast must catch fire in our homes. The beast must catch fire in our workplaces. The beast must catch fire in our nation. The beast must catch fire. The beast must catch fire in this church. The beast must catch fire. 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 Wherever you are, wherever you're hiding, we smoke you out. We roast you by fire. We smoke you out. We roast you by fire in our workplaces. We smoke you out. We roast you by fire in our homes, in our families, in our villages, in our towns, in our cities, in our communities, in our locations, in our streets. We smoke you out and we roast you by fire. We smoke you out and we roast you by fire. We smoke you out and we roast you by fire. We smoke you out and we roast you. Ay 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 ay. Shakatali gaga, yakatari gaga, yakatari gaga, yakatari gaga. Somebody pray like a warrior, pray like a soldier, pray like a warrior. You are praying on ground, online, wherever you are. Rise in the spirit, rise in the power of the Holy Ghost against every beast of your life, every beast that wanted to finish you, every beast that wanted to scatter your life. You are rising like a soldier, you are rising like a man and a woman of authority against every demonic beast in the name of Jesus. Masatari gada, yakatari 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 gada, yakarabarabarabusya, yakarabarabarabusya, yakatarabarabarabusya. My God, shakatari gada, in Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. We now want to send fire. Somebody shout, I want to send fire. Say it loud, I want to send fire. So we are going to do this 1 minute per session. How many minutes? 1 minute. 1 minute per dimension. Because we are sending what? Fire. Somebody shout, I am a fire distributor. Hallelujah. Number one, you are sending fire. Now the moment I mention a thing, you send fire like a fire brigade. Somebody shout, I am a fire brigade. And you are distributing fire, sir. You are distributing fire. This time you're going to say, Father, I'm sending fire to my workplace or my place of business or whatever you do. You are going to say, I am sending fire to my workplace, to my place of business, to burn every beast there. Is it making sense? Lift your voice, do that. I'm sending fire to my workplace, to my place of business, to my place of residence. I am sending fire to my workplace, to my place of business, to burn every beast there, to burn every beast, 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 to burn every beast. I am sending fire to my workplace. I am sending fire to my place of business. I am sending fire to my offices, to burn every beast, to burn every beast, to burn every beast there, to burn every beast in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name. Now, you are sending fire into your home, into your marriage, and into your family to burn every beast there. You are sending fire into your home, marriage, and family to burn every beast that may be there. Lift your voice, lift your voice. I am sending fire into my home, into my marriage, into my family, into my home village to burn every beast there, to burn every beast there, to burn every beast there. I am sending fire into my home, into my marriage, into my family to burn every available beast, to burn every available beast, to burn every available beast in the name of Jesus. Every beast in my home, in my marriage, in my family, you are roasted by fire. I burn you by fire. I burn you by fire. I burn you right now. I burn you right now. I burn you right now in the name of Jesus. Now, you are now sending fire to State House and every office in this nation to burn every satanic beast in those places. Is it making sense? Lord, right now I'm sending fire into State House and every government office. I am sending fire into every office in the public, private sector, anything that is called an office. I am sending the fire of the Holy Ghost there, all around the nation, to burn every beast that may be available in those places. Lift your voice. We are sending fire to State House and every office in this nation to burn every beast, to burn every beast, to burn every beast, that every beast that has been suffocating the affairs of this nation, the progress of this nation. Whether you are at State House, whether you are in any office, government office, public office, private office, I decree right now, yes, you beast in those places, in those offices, you are burning by fire. You are roasted by fire. You are burning right now. You are burning right now. You are burning right now. We are sending the fire of the Holy Ghost to State House. We are sending the fire of the Holy Ghost to every office, every office, every office, every place of work in this nation to burn every beast, 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 to burn the enemies of this nation, to burn the enemies of this nation, to burn the enemies of our lives, the enemies of our progress, the enemies of our success, the enemies of God's will in this land, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Now hear me. Now you are sending fire to every home of this nation to burn every beast there. You are sending fire to every home, every residence in this nation to burn every beast. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Father, I am now sending fire to every home of this nation, to every residence, every community, every residence, every location of this nation to burn every beast, 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 to burn every beast in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we are sending the fire of the Holy Ghost to every home of this nation to burn every satanic beast, to burn every demonic beast in those homes, in the name of Jesus, 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 in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Now this time you are sending fire to every river, every lake, every dam, every pond and every water body in this nation to burn every beast there. You are sending the fire of the Holy Ghost to every river, every lake, every dam, every pond, and every other water body in this nation to burn every beast, to burn marine spirits. Lift your voice, send the fire. Please, people, pray like a warrior, pray like a warrior. Wherever you are, pray like a warrior. I am sending fire to every river, every lake, every dam, every pond, every water body in this nation to burn every beast, 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 to burn marine spirits, to burn water spirits, to burn water spirits, to burn satanic powers that operate from the waters. In the name of Jesus, I am sending the fire of the Holy Ghost to the underworld, to every river, to every lake, to every dam, to every pond, to every water body in this nation, to burn every beast, 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 to burn every beast. In the name of Jesus. Now you are going to pray. Now this time you are sending fire to every space of this nation to burn every beast, to every space, every location, every area of this nation to burn every beast. Lift your voice. I am sending fire, the fire of the Holy Ghost, to every location, to every sphere, to every space of this nation to burn every beast, 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 to burn every beast. Lift your voice, everybody. In the name of Jesus, I am sending the fire of the Holy Ghost to every space of this nation to burn every beast there, to burn every beast there, to burn every beast there. In the name of Jesus. Now, I want you to pray. This time around, you are sending fire to every day of this year to burn every beast. You are sending fire. You are releasing fire, the fire of the Holy Ghost, on every day of this year to the 31st of December 2021. You are saying that on every day of this year, I'm sending fire to burn every beast associated with each day. Now. Some of you need to understand this. Matthew chapter 6 and verse number 34. Matthew chapter 6 and verse number 34. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about its own things. Now hear this. It says, sufficient for the day is its own trouble. So there is trouble associated with each day of the year. Is it making sense? We are sending fire to each and every day of this year to burn the beast of troubles associated with each and every day. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. Ha ha! Shakataragadalabasaya. I am sending fire, the fire of the Holy Ghost, to every day of this year to burn every beast, to burn every beast of trouble, every beast of calamity, every beast of pain associated with each day, associated with each day. In the name of Jesus, I send the fire of the Holy Ghost to every day of this year, 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 to burn every beast, to burn every beast associated with each day, the beast of sickness, the beast of disease, the beast of premature death, the beast of calamities, the beast of confusion. In the name of Jesus, I send the fire of the Holy Ghost, the fire of the Holy Ghost, to every day of this year, to every day of this year, to every day of this year, to burn every beast, 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 in the mighty name of Jesus. My God, now, lastly, you are sending, my God, the fire of the Holy Ghost into your body system to burn every known and unknown sickness and disease in your body. Remember, this is a healing service. Lift your voice. Lift your voice. I am now sending the fire of the Holy Ghost into my body, into my system, into my body to burn every known and unknown sickness and disease in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I am sending the fire of the Holy Ghost into my body system to roast every sickness, every disease, every infirmity, known and unknown, in my body, in the mighty name of Jesus, 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 in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Lift up to answer the Father. I decree this hour that every beast associated with your life dies by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Poverty dies by fire in the name of Jesus. Premature death dies by fire in the name of Jesus. All agents of darkness against your life, against your family, against this church, against this nation, they are all dead by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. All enemies of this church, all enemies of your life, are roasted by fire. They are roasted by fire. All enemies masquerading as friends are roasted by fire. I said they are roasted by fire. They are roasted by fire. They are roasted by fire. Come on, lift your voice and appreciate God for victory this morning. Come on, everyone, lift your voice wherever you are. Appreciate God for victory. Appreciate God for victory. Something good has happened. Something good, wonderful has happened. Something glorious, something envy generating has happened unto you. Financially, in business, in health, in career, in all dimensions of your life. Somebody lift your voice. Somebody lift your voice. Give God thanks. Because all your beasts have been roasted by fire. All the beasts have been roasted by fire. Thank you, mighty God. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Somebody clap your hands for the King of Kings. Glory be to God. I said, glory be to God. I said, glory be to God. Psalm 23 and verse number 6. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. God bless you.
There is power in the blood
to break
the chains of bondage,
and set the captives free.
To set the captives free.
The blood
of Jesus.
There is power.